Phoenix, Kelli Ward, the fractious leader of the Arizona Republican Party, narrowly beat back significant competition on Saturday to win another two-year term as the organization's chairwoman despite the endorsement of former President Donald Trump. The closely watched result offers an early, state-level indication that Trump retains sway over the activist base of the GOP, though it is more tenuous. The election also suggests the long-standing divisions in the state party in the Trump era have not abated. Ward's re-election was considered a foregone conclusion weeks ago, but many in the GOP had misgivings about the party's past electoral performance on her watch and an uncertain future heading into the 2022 midterm elections. Under Ward, the state GOP joined a failed lawsuit against Vice President Mike Pence seeking to allow him to overturn the election results. She also urged Pence on Twitter to adjourn Congress to allow state legislatures to overturn their results. The state party often used incendiary messaging since President Joe Biden's victory, including one social media post asking supporters if they were willing to give their lives in the fight to overturn the election, and helped establish a baseline of radicalism for conservatives that culminated in the invasion of the Capitol. Later Saturday, the state Republican Party members passed three resolutions censuring high-profile Republicans, Governor Doug Ducey, former Senator Jeff Flake and Cindy McCain. It was another sign of the party's move to the right. The party censured Ducey over his decision to impose emergency rules during the pandemic that the GOP said restrict personal liberties and force compliance to unconstitutional edicts. McCain, who endorsed President Joe Biden, has supported globalist policies and candidates, and condemned President Trump for his criticism of her husband and erroneously placed behaviors over actual presidential results. Flake has condemned the Republican Party, rejected populism, and rejected the interests of the American people over globalist interests. The party suggested Flake join the Democrats. Sarah Mueller, Ducey's political director, took the censure in stride. These resolutions are of no consequence whatsoever, and the people behind them have lost whatever little moral authority they may have once had, she said. J.P. Twist, Ducey's former campaign manager who now is the political director of the Republican Governors Association that Ducey heads, suggested financial reprisals for the state party. And with that, the ACGOP will have no significant role in 22. No other option but to work with others. We've been here before. No big deal, he said in a tweet after the vote. McCain in a tweet alluded to her late husband Senator John McCain's own battles with the party. It is a high honor to be included in a group of Arizonans who have served our state and our nation so well, and who, like my late husband John, have been censured by the AZGOP.